As you know, we can use the law of sines sometimes to solve oblique triangles. Turns out that the law of sines is sometimes not enough. So we need another strategy to solve some triangles. So we're going to talk about the law of cosines, and I want to show you where it comes from. There is nothing particularly special about this triangle. I just put it on the Cartesian coordinate plane to make it easier for us to work with. I put one vertex here at the origin, we'll call it A. Another vertex is here on the x-axis, and we'll call that B. And the third vertex of this triangle, B, point C. Let me label the sides. We know opposite angle A is side A, opposite angle B is side B, and opposite angle C is side C. So down here we have side C. And let me label some ordered pairs. If this length is C, then this point right here could be considered C0. Now this point up here, I just want to call it XY. I don't know where it is, except that it's up here in the first quadrant. So it's just sort of a generic XY. I do want to drop an altitude, though, from C down to the opposite side. And, of course, that means it's a right angle right here. And because C is the point XY, I know this length right here would be X. Let me label that. And the altitude here would be Y, since this point is XY. So over X, up Y to get to the point XY. Now let's use our distance formula, and this is the key to coming up with the law of cosines. We're going to use the distance formula with these two points, and we'll be finding this distance, but we know that distance is A. So let's use our distance formula, which says the distance between two points is the square root of x2 minus x1 squared, which is, in this case, is x minus c squared plus y2 minus y1 squared, which is y minus 0 squared. And so this is our distance between these two points, but we know that that distance is A. So let's set it equal to A. Now I would like to get rid of this square root, so let's square both sides. So we have A squared equals X minus C squared plus, now this zero isn't doing very much, so let's just write it as Y squared. And we can continue by multiplying this out. So this binomial, we're gonna square the binomial. So we'd have A squared equals X squared minus 2XC plus C squared, and we still have the Y squared. Now I just feel like rearranging the terms, so let me do that. I'm gonna have a squared equals, I'm gonna write the x squared and the y squared together. And then I'm gonna have the plus c squared and the minus 2xc. And now I wanna come back to this triangle. Notice over here, we have this right triangle right here. And within this right triangle, we know the Pythagorean theorem would hold, because it does hold for any right triangle. So x squared plus y squared would equal b squared, because b is the hypotenuse of that triangle. So I'm going to replace this x squared plus y squared with b squared. So a squared equals b squared plus c squared minus 2xc. And again, it was because of the x squared plus y squared equals b squared from this triangle on the left. Now, we still have an x here in our formula, and I want to take care of that next. Let's look at this triangle here. Within, again, this triangle on the left, we know that there's a relationship between this angle, the adjacent side, and the hypotenuse, and we know it's this, that the cosine of A would equal x over b, or x equals b cosine A. We're going to make that substitution over here. So we have a squared equals b squared plus c squared minus 2. Now here comes our substitution. Our x is b cosine a times c. Now let's rearrange this to make it look a little bit nicer. We have a squared equals b squared plus c squared minus, and let's rearrange this to make it nicer. We have 2bc cosine a. And this is our law of cosines. Now with any particular triangle, we have other versions. We could, instead of having a squared over here, we could put b squared or c squared there. Let me just show you how that would look. So we have this as our law of cosines, but as an alternative, it could have been written like this. Let me come down here. Well, I'm just gonna go right on top, right here. B squared equals the sum of the squares of the other two sides minus 2 times the product of those two sides times the cosine of the angle that is opposite this side. So when I'm looking at my law of cosines, I know this angle and this side are kind of a match. And the third version is c squared equals, again, the sum of the squares of the other two sides, b squared plus, I don't know why I put the b squared first, a squared plus b squared minus 2ab cosine c. And again, this angle and this side are a match. Notice it was the case down here. Here was the cosine of a and that was side a. So it really is the same formula three times. And I do want to last point out one thing. If C were a right angle, so for example, we had a triangle that looked like this, where this were angle C, this would be C, this would be A, and this would be B, or could be. If C is a right angle, the formula is now C squared equals A squared plus B squared minus 2AB cosine of now 90 degrees, but we know the cosine of 90 degrees is zero. So we have c squared equals a squared plus b squared minus 2 times a times b times zero. That essentially wipes out that term, and we have c squared equals a squared plus b squared, or the Pythagorean theorem. In other words, the law of cosines could be thought of as a generalization of the Pythagorean theorem that would work for any triangle. And I think of this as the fudge factor that you need if this angle is not 90 degrees.